There was no way we were going to put my sister in a hospice, because that meant we were giving up. And I think from a cultural lens as well, this isn't something that many of us in my community in particular would consider doing. Because it does just mean, you know, you're withdrawing everything and you've just given up on her. And but when the ironic thing was that when I used to go back and forth from Canada to England, that's where my sister was. The ironic thing was that I used to, you know, say to the doctors in the hospital, you have to fix this now, and you've got to fix this, and it was surgery after surgery. And they would say, well, okay, we'll do it. But you do know that she's palliative, right? I didn't fully understand that at that time, to be honest. It was like, what do you mean? Or maybe I just didn't take that in. But I'd say, well, no, if you fix this, you're telling me that something here is wrong inside her. Fix it and it'll be better. I wasn't accepting the fact that it'll only be better for a few weeks and then something else is going to go inside her system. And so there came a time when she said no more surgeries. And so she had a discussion with the hospice staff nurses. And she had the hospice staff nurse call me in Canada to say, tell my sister this is what I've decided, because I know she wants me to live. But this is not what I want. And in those days, I wasn't there. That is the patient's right and the patient's preference, not what you want. So for her, the quality of life wasn't there anymore, and she just wanted to be, she didn't want any more surgery, she didn't want any more treatment. She wanted to be sent home, and she wanted to have her last moments in her home. And that's what happened.